Well, hello there.
What's poppin', Pokemon people? Some of you might already know me as Frosted Caribou. I open up TCG products on my YouTube channel, and I'm also a TCG player extraordinaire that played two Crobats on one turn.
Wait, you can't Crobat twice on one turn? It's like Dedenne? Did not know that.
But that's besides the point, okay? So, this is a way more low-key video than I usually do. Welcome, it's nighttime. So, I've been unemployed. Hi, how are ya? And in that time has been the rise of Champion's Path, the latest, the greatest new specialty Pokemon set with the two Charizard chase cards, okay? And with that came low allocation of the product, people not being able to find it anywhere, stores canceling pre-orders, scammers, scalpers, grandmas buying tons of product from Walmarts. It's caused chaos amongst the Pokemon community. And I have had a lot of extra time on my hands lately to just spend on my YouTube channel making content and researching more about Pokemon. And I know the TCG side of Pokemon, and I know that I enjoy opening packs, but I didn't know very much about the collector side of things, so I wanted to do some research, which is where this video stems from. And I know what you're thinking, okay? Why would I trust some random chick wearing Psyduck slippers and eating grocery store sushi with Pokemon investment opinions? And to that I say, I understand. But hear me out. So we all know Champion's Path. An ETB of it comes with 10 packs, sleeves, dice, damage counters, and that beautiful full art Charizard promo. ETBs retail at $50 a piece, but nobody can find them, which means people are reselling them for higher prices. On the lower end of that spectrum is $90, the higher end being like $105. Now luckily, we have something to compare Champion's Path to, and that is Hidden Fates. Now obviously these two sets have their differences, but they're very, very similar to each other at the same time. Hidden Fates ETB retailed for $50, it came with 10 packs, and it also came with that beautiful Bird Trio promo card. So now we just take a look at where Hidden Fates is today, about a year after it came out. Hidden Fates ETB is selling from $300 to $350 on average. Now why is it selling for that much? Because that Trio Bird card that comes in the set, if you grade that a PSA 10, it sells from $300 to $350. Now packs of Hidden Fates are going from $10 to $15, and you might be like,
wait,
why are they so cheap if an ETB that comes with 10 packs of Hidden Fates is $300 to $350? And the answer to that, in my opinion, is that Hidden Fates is a super popular set. Don't get me wrong, but as an investor or a collector, you just buy the singles, the raw versions of the cards or the full arts for your collection or to invest in, rather than trying to buy packs to pull those cards. Especially because the Hidden Fates packs, if you're not pulling baby shinies, they're pretty garbage, let's be real. So I think the price of Hidden Fates packs are consistently remaining around $10 to $15, primarily because of the age of the set. No one feels good spending more than $15 on a set that has a ton of filler cards and it's only a year old. But as I said earlier, a sealed one of those ETBs is selling from $3 to $350 on average, some of them going up to $500. So take a $50 ETB and sell it a year later for $500. That's bananas. That's just insane. So you could crack the ETB, send the promo in to get graded, hope that it gets a 10. You could sell the packs off individually, $10 to $15, so you're netting like $100 to $150 off the packs, or you could open the packs, hope you pull other good full art shinies, send those in to get graded to sell those, but if you pull nothing, that sucks. Or you could just sell the sealed ETBs from $300 all the way up to $500 a year later and not have to deal with all the work of getting them graded or selling the packs individually or any of that. So in my opinion, I think the ETBs are way, way, way easier to move as far as selling product goes. So now let's look at Champion's Path. You're trying to figure out whether you want to buy single packs of it or if you want to buy the ETBs. So let's say you want to buy 500 Champion's Path singular individual packs. On average, packs are being sold for $7.50. So if you bought 500 packs, it would cost you $3,750. So now let's look at the ETBs. I did the math on this. You can get 42 ETBs for $3,780. So that's a $30 difference from the 500 individual packs you bought. But you're only getting 420 packs if you buy the ETBs at $90 a piece. A couple other metrics just for the price gougers. Instead of at 90, you're buying them at 97, it's gonna be $4,075. If you're buying them at 105, which is usually on the high end of what the resellers are selling them for, it's gonna be $4,410. So that's a difference of 80 packs, but you get the Full Art Charizard promos from the ETBs. And the Full Art Charizard promos are selling raw.
Where's the lamb sauce?
From $20 to $25. So if you sell 42 of those raw Charizard promos for $20, that's $840. Or if you sell 42 raw for $25, that's $1,050. So you're losing 80 packs, but you can sell all of the raw promos and make up much more of that money potentially in the long run. So what if you're like, well, I don't want to sell the promos raw, I want to get them graded. Well, that's cool too. Compared to the Hidden Fates Bird Trio promo, I couldn't find a sold PSA 9, but based on the PSA 8 and the PSA 10, I would estimate a PSA 9 Bird Trio promo would sell for like $100 to $150. The PSA 10, as I said before, was $300 to $350 for the PSA 10 Bird Trio. While this is a super beautiful promo card and it's amazing, you have to remember the Champion's Path promo is a Charizard. I would easily guess that comparable to the Hidden Fates promo, a year from Champion's Path coming out, one of those PSA 10 Full Art Charizard cards will probably be selling from $500 to $700 easily. I know the Bird PSA 10 is $300 to $350, but Charizard is a coveted card and I could see that price jumping just simply because it's a Charizard. So for the conclusion of this video, I'm not just gonna sit here and be like,
you have to buy this, you have to do this, this is the best scenario.
Because genuinely, I've learned there's a lot of factors and variables that go into collecting and investing that really just depend on you and your preference. Are you the type of person that can just buy a $50 ETB, leave it alone and keep it sealed for an entire year? Sweet. That is the safest way to ensure that this ETB is going to hold way more value a year from now than it is today. But what if you like the chase? What if you like the sound of opening a Pokemon pack or the smell of the fresh cardboard? Or you want to see if you can be the person to pull that shiny Charizard or Rainbow Charizard? If that's all you're trying to do is pull a Charizard, just buy single packs. That's the easiest, fastest, and cheapest way to just buy a bunch of packs, gamble with it, and try to pull that Charizard. Now, let's say you want to open packs and you can't keep that ETB sealed. That's okay too, you can still open it. The promo inside is already selling raw for $20 to $25. So if you don't wanna go grade that promo and hope to get a good grade on it, you can just sell it raw for half the price you paid for the ETB. Then you can still open the packs and hope to pull something good. And then you can sell, you know, if you pull the shiny Charizard, sell that baby for $500, man. Sell that baby. Heck, send that sucker to get graded and he's an even higher value. So it's not the end of the world if you open your ETB, but of course, the more risk you take, the harder you fall sometimes. So you could open all those packs and pull absolutely nothing. It's still not the end of the world. Luckily for Champion's Path ETBs, you still have that Charizard Full Art promo. So if you can, go send it to get graded and then hang on to it because you know for a fact the price on that is only gonna go up. So potentially, if you pull trash, you still have the safety net of the Charizard Flirt promo, and you can sell the rest of the contents within the box as well. Now, of course, you want to purchase the ETB as low as possible, but if you have to purchase it at a higher cost, you still have the potential to make a profit off of purchasing it for more. So really, when it comes down to collecting and investing into Champion's Path, it all is personal preference. How much time and patience do you have? Can you keep the product sealed? How much money can you initially invest into it? Do you have the means to go get the cards graded? Can you wait an ample amount of time to just double your investment on the product? Hopefully, I've given you enough information in this video for you to now go out and make that decision yourself. Now, as a TCG player, do not buy this set. I don't care if you like opening packs, go buy a better set that's better for TCG playing, because a majority of these cards in this set are terrible for playing the TCG. So if you like opening packs, go get a booster box of Sword and Shield base set, Rival Clash, Darkness Ablaze, any other set. This is not a TCG player focused set. It's just not. I'm sponsored by Flipside Gaming, and they sell singles for decks on their site. You can use code Pokeboo for 10% off, and you can also use code Pokeboo for digital code cards from PoTownStore.com as well if you are a digital TCG player. Now, hopefully, after watching this, I'm a little bit more credible to you, maybe. And now I can give you my fun Boo investment tip. You remember when I said Hidden Fates ETBs were selling for $300 to $350 right now? But a PSA 10 promo bird from that Hidden Fates ETB is selling for $300 to $350 right now. Well, that's a bunch of free Hidden Fates packs. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. It was super fun researching and filming it. I can feel myself slowly becoming a Pokemon collector and investor, and I like it. If you want to see more videos like this, please let me know down in the comments, because this is so not normal for my content, but I really enjoyed it. So if you guys enjoy it too, I can do more of these. And if you personally have any of your own opinions, or I left something out of this video, leave those below as well. That'd be super cool. I like this discussion, so yay. Thank you to all my patrons. I love you guys so much, and I will catch you guys later. Bye-bye-bye!